Hello. Amanda sent me this in a beer mail. It's the Chiltern Brewery, the Lord Lieutenant Porter. The oldest independent brewery in the Chilterns. Let's have a look. What else is this? Here. There's a picture of a little fox. It says, "Fear God and give him the glory." 1980. Ciba, the British Bottlers Institute, it's bottle conditioned, British flag. Looks good. Suppose I should age this, but beer's meant to be drunk. Plain blue cap. Smokiness, little sign of some sort of residue on the top that I don't like the look of. Just give me a second. I think that's sediment, but anyway, that's the pour. Light brown, chocolatey head. Chocolatey, I'd say dark, maybe. Rich mahogany colour to it. Can hardly see anything through it. Smells like chocolate as well. Cheers. Wow, this is a big glass. There's a slight alcohol taste to it. Lots of heavy biscuit note. Right. It's got a lot of words here. Let's have a look. This deluxe porter was launched on our 20th anniversary in 2000 by Sir Nigel Mobbs, KSTJJP. Lord Lieutenant for Buckinghamshire was. Who charged the coppers with choice hops on the first brew? The lieutenancy is one of the most ancient offices of England, dating from 1535 in Buckinghamshire. We are partly pleased to display the lieutenancy colours around the border. Our inspiration derived from the famous London porters of the early 1700s, blending our own in proportions of carefully selected premium quality roasted malts with full cone Challenger, Fuggles, and Golden hops, all from England. The powerful punch is initially disguised by the cream, crackerish, dry sweet biscuit sensations, followed by unmistakable rich smoky flavours of full mash malts. We're almost there. Our Ruby Porter is more than capable of entertaining you on its own, but also makes an ideal accompaniment to oysters. Yeah, no oysters in this house. Unless it's oyster stout. It provides fortification for strong cheeses. I do like my cheeses. And ballast for our own Lord Lieutenant's Christmas pudding, with the compliments of the head brewer, Tom. What was it? I don't know what it says there. Cool story. Really nice design on the bottles. The head's dissipating now. It does have the faint smell of Christmas pudding. And it does remind me of something else. I am getting like a smokiness now as it's warmed because I've had it in the fridge today, but just see what that is. That's as you can see, it's like a paste of some sort, but the smell is getting more easy now. It's incredibly creamy. You know this is going in my bottle collection because it's very nice. I do recommend it. Anyone that sees this buy this because it's very tasty. I feel kind of posh now drinking it, but it's a very nice drink. As you can see, try get that what that smell is. But it's very rich in smell. So nice. Anyway, I've just noticed the time. So you take care. I'm gonna enjoy this. Goodbye.